Incredible pictures that contain all the information of a set of equations that are related to string theory. And it's even more bizarre than that, because when you then try to understand these pictures, you find out that buried in them are computer codes just like the type that you find in a browser when you go surf the web. And so I'm left with the puzzle of trying to figure out whether I live in the Matrix or not.
Wait, you're blowing my mind at this moment. So you're saying, your attempt to understand the fundamental operations of nature leads you to a set of equations that are indistinguishable from the equations that drive search engines and browsers on our computers?
That is correct. So,
Wait. I have to just be silent for a minute here. So you're saying as you dig deeper, you find computer code writ in the fabric of the cosmos.
Into the equations that we want to use to describe the cosmos, yes.
Computer code.
Computer code, strings of bits of ones and zeros.
It's not just sort of resembles computer code, you're saying it is computer code.
It's not even just is computer code, it's a special kind of computer code that was invented by a scientist named Claude Shannon in the 1940s. That's what we find buried very deeply inside the equations that occur in string theory and in general in systems that we can say are supersymmetric.
Time to go home, I think. I mean, where are we going to go? So are you saying we are all just, there's some entity that programmed the universe and we're just expressions of their code?
Well, I didn't say that.
Like the Matrix? Thank you. saying we are all just, there's some entity that programmed the universe, and we're just expressions of their code?